Hello, everybody, and welcome back finally to Higurashi When They Cry, Chapter 1. I should probably give you some sort of quick explanation. This obviously isn't going to really apply to people that watch the series in the future, but there was a one-year gap between the last episode and this one. In fact, the last episode was recorded, I believe, and also uploaded on the 11th of January, 2022. I apologize about taking so long to get back to this. It wasn't anything to do with the game. It was basically that I got a new PC, and I didn't carry over any of the files with me, and I didn't want to go through the process of downloading the mod again until I was done with some of the other stuff I was working on, and I just kind of kept pushing Higurashi off to the side. But no more. It is the 3rd of February, 2023. And I'm playing this fucking... We're finishing this damn visual novel because I want to. Now let's turn the light off. Now some things have changed since the last time. I believe I was using Bandicam to record last time. I've since switched to using only OBS. So videos will probably... I might still average them out around the 40-minute mark, but I usually these days record videos up to an hour and average them out around there. But we'll just see how it goes. Regardless, though, I got the mod reinstalled, and hopefully I did see, I believe, an extra chapter jump. I don't know what chapter jump does. All right, it's the creepy music. I believe we looked at these, because I think I looked at these every time we get a new one unlocked, right? Okay, because I did check where we were last... Yeah, okay, I remember. Okay. I'm gonna hope we looked at these. If I didn't, someone can let me know in the comment section, and I'll go back through them just to make sure. I do actually have notes, just like when I'm doing thoughts and opinions. Unfortunately, though, I don't know where the fuck they are in here, because I've done quite a bit since we last played. But I'm hoping that it actually did cloud save my save file, and I'm hoping that it works with the mod and everything. So we'll just have to see. If it doesn't, then there's going to be a weird cut here, and then I'll have to play through the game again. But if I go to continue... right here, I believe this is where we were. Load. January 11th, 2022 at 4:33 in the morning. It is currently midnight. It's 12:33 right now, so... Almost. Holy Jesus Christ. Okay, I think we're back in. Now, hopefully all of my mod settings are the same. I tried to set everything up the same way I thought I had it before. If it's not, again, let me know and I'll try to fix that. Can I find, before we actually continue here, can I find... my Higurashi notes. There are Higurashi manga notes that I'm finding. That's not what I'm looking for. Oh, yes. Princess Mononoke. A taxi. Higurashi Go. And the infinite notes I took on that back in the day. Holy shit. So it's middle of the night. Got my light off because, of course I do. Gotta have... Okay, apparently I just... I found it. Oh my god, okay. I'm gonna set this off to the side. I'll just look at that later, it doesn't fucking matter. Okay. Mion? I've missed Mion. Oh my god. And I have to just break in here and say that since the last time we played, I've gone through a full franchise anime rewatch of Higurashi, watched everything, including the spinoffs and the stuff I didn't really like. And I'm even doing another rewatch right now. And now I'm getting messages, which is quite annoying because I just said that I would be busy. So let me mute my phone quick so that we don't have that popping up in the midst of anything important. And I'm actually rewatching it again right now, so we'll have to see if I can. I am doing awesome, actually, because I haven't recorded shit in a long time that was of this caliber.
Keiichi-wa yasundemasukedo. Kawarimashouka.
Suppose I can put it on auto. I don't know. No, I don't want to put it on auto. No. That is such a Keiichi laugh, holy shit. After our exchange, we both had a good laugh together. Except I was suspicious of her even as we were laughing. Was everybody really involved in the incidents? The fact that I couldn't say no saddened me.
レナもすっごく心配してたよ。サトコはじゃまあないですわって喜んでたな。リカちゃんは病気でかわいそうかわいそうですってさ。ちぇ、みんなで勝手に大盛り上がりしてたみたいだな。まあまあ。でさ、ケイちゃん。
お見舞いに行っちゃ都合悪いかな。Yes. Oops. Oh, a ton of mochi. I've never had it.
おつわけに持ってけって言ってんだよ。だから持ってくね。おいおい。風が移っても知らねえぞ。おじさんもレナもおバカさんだから大丈夫。
Both Rena and I are too stupid to catch a cold. I didn't know colds gave a shit about your stupidity. She hung up cheerfully, as Mion do. Mion's a nice character. That's what it sounded like. I was still concerned about meeting Rena, but I guess if she was with Mion... I guess I could try... auto. I just don't want it to rush through too quickly. But I also don't want to annoy you guys with my clicking, because I know that can pick up on that. I heard the doorbell 10 minutes later. It's almost like we live in a small-ass village.
どんな感じ?
Oh, Jesus! Okay, that volume. I'm going to need to mix that volume a little bit better on my end. I think it should be okay for you guys, but I hope you can't hear it through my headset. I guess we'll find out. I'll do one episode and then test it out and see if you can hear my audio through my headset, then I'll need to do some fixing with that.
ちゃんと薬飲んで寝てた?
Oh, piss off. I ain't taking no medicine.
それはもうしっかりとな。
元気そうでよかった。 心配してたんだよ。
Mion showed a complete lack of concern for someone who's recovering, and Rena looked like she was worried about me from the bottom of her heart. That's Rena for you, because she's the sweetest little thing, except when she's not. It didn't look like there was anything behind those expressions.
Because obviously we're...
The paranoia is starting to set in.
So-ka?
It seemed my face appeared a bit sullen.
じゃあこれ、ケイチ君。ケイチ君。みーちゃんのおばあちゃんが作ってくれたおはぎだよ。おはぎ。
Can I just not? Rena held out the package wrapped in newspaper. There might be about 5 in here. It was quite hefty.
Ah, thank you, na. Mion no ba-chan ni yoroshiku tsutaetoite kure yo.
その中にね、レナが作ったのも混じってるんだよ。
Oh, especially made, handmade one by Rena.
ケイチ君に見つけられるかな。
これ、今日の部活を欠席したケイちゃんへの宿題ね。
Bah.
おはぎにアルファベットがついてるから、明日回答すること。
お見舞いなのか部活なのか、どっちかにしろ。
うんうん、元気元気。これなら明日は大丈夫そうだね。
この騒ぎで熱がぶり返したらどうしてくれんだよ、まったく。
みーちゃん、あんまり騒いじゃ悪いよ。もう行こう。お家の人にも怒られるよ。
Both of them thought my parents weren't home, or were home, excuse me. It was because the entranceway was a mess. Yeah, I can see...absolutely fuck all in the entranceway. Total mess. The umbrellas are neatly... Why are there 3? I guess there's 1 per person in the household. I've don't own an umbrella.
そうだね。もう行こっかね。あ、そうそう、ケイちゃん。
なんだよ。
お昼、何食べた?
Excuse me?I had a pothole pizza for lunch, from the local gas station. The sudden question startled me, and I went wide-eyed when I saw Mion. I had never seen her like that. It was a highly unsettling visage. But why is she asking me about what I ate for lunch? What she said was so inane it was almost meaningless. The way she said it, it was almost like she didn't even care at all about what I ate.
Oh, 表で食べたよ。
She must have suspected that I was with Oishi-san. Anyway, I felt that if I hesitated or tried to change the subject, then they'd read too deep into it, so I tried answering as quickly as possible. Except, contrary to the efforts I had made, there was a pause before they replied.
Keiichi-kun, お昼は外食だったんだね。
The glimmer from Rena's eyes had changed at some point as well.It was now sharp, as if to make me feel the feigned ignorance behind her words even more. As if she already knew. That's how it looked to me.
どう?美味しかった?
なんでそんなことを聞くんだよ?
Mion was speaking in an unusually low tone, almost as if she knew that I had eaten at the restaurant in town. No, I'm overthinking this. I mean, both of them should have been in school at lunchtime. There was no way they could have known where I was.
渋いおじさまとご一緒だったみたいだけど。誰?
The package with the mochi I was holding slipped out of my hands. I could tell the blood had drained from my face, making me go pale.
へぇ。ケイチ君、それ誰?ひょっとして、この間の人かな?かな?
I was waiting for the double kana. Sorry, I had to have my Higurashi moment. I could feel the back of my throat going dry. This was no longer a bluff. They knew everything.
なんでそんなことわかるんだよ?
It took everything I had to finally force those words from my throat. My knees were shaking.
さてね。おじさんにわからないことはないからね。
Mion sneered knowingly, and her laugh seemed to carry on forever.
で、ケイちゃん、何のお話をしてたの?
Excuse me, but that's none of your business, Mion.
ずいぶんと熱くなってたみたいだけど。
みんなの話はしてないよ。Mionともレナとも関係ない。
That is exactly what you do not say, Keiichi, because that will draw attention to what you were talking about.
Hmm? 聞いてもないのにレナたちの名前が出るなんて、なんだか怪しいな。
Yeah, no shit, dumbass. Why the fuck did you say that? Rena's unwavering gaze pierced through my eyes and peered further inside me. I dug my own grave. My heart was throbbing so much it felt like I was going to explode. It was going to explode.
何を隠れてやろうとも、おじさんにはすべてお見通しってこと。それだけを忘れないでくれればいいかな。
Spare me. I couldn't even shake my head. It took everything I had to stop my teeth from chattering. She never let her gaze break from mine, even as she tilted her head slightly.
Keiichi-kun, 顔色悪いよ。
I'm hungry.
もう横になった方がいいと思うな。
Now how about I go eat this mochi and you guys get the fuck out of my house?
そうだね。私たちはもう帰ろう。
Actually, on second thought, I don't want your mochi. How about you take it back? You guys have it. I have food in the fridge. What even is mochi? Isn't it like supposed to be like a sweet bean paste or something? As if nothing had happened, they both giggled at each other and started making their way out. Well, that was easy. I hadn't moved a muscle since I had dropped the package of mochi. As they left, the door slowly closed behind them. All I could do was stare. As if I couldn't move until the door was completely closed. Just as the door was about to close, it opened again slightly with a sudden creak, sending my heart racing once again. Excuse me. A single eye peered in through that narrow slit, and Mion's hawkish gaze peered at me once again. Mion is the one staring through the thing?
じゃあね、ケイちゃん。
That's new.
Oh.
明日、学校休んじゃ、嫌だよ。
Uh-huh, I'll be there. Thud. The door closed. I wasn't able to move a muscle, even after their low laughter died off into the distance and silence once again enveloped the room. Coming back to my senses, the first thing I did was lock the door. They knew what Oishi-san and I talked about? Why? How? No, that wasn't important. Thinking about it now, all of it could have been overheard from the beginning when Oishi-san met me. Just as Mion said, I couldn't hide anything. Then, what were they trying to tell me? That part was obvious. They were warning me not to say anything unnecessary. What did they deem unnecessary? I only talked with Oishi-san about one thing, and they were warning me that that was unnecessary. What was it that Oishi-san talked to me about? The incidents involving Oyashiro-sama's curse that occurred every year weren't individual cases, but were connected as a whole. As well as the fact that there may be multiple perpetrators hidden within Hinamizawa. No, more precisely, that Mion, Rena, Sotoko, and Rika-chan were all suspicious. Is that what they were warning me against?
Nani baka no koto kangaeten da yo, ore!
I hit my own face hard enough that it let out a loud slap. If only that would wake me from this nightmare, but for some reason it felt like I was pinching a blanket. It was almost laughably painless. Calm down, Keiichi Maibara. When did I become such a pessimist? Calm down. Calm down. Settle down and sort things out. The reason Mio knew I was eating lunch with Oishi-san was probably because somebody from Hinamizawa just happened to be there at the time. They must have told Mio that I was there. That made the most sense. Plus, come to think of it, she didn't ask me where I ate lunch, did she? She only asked, was it good? They were just curious since I was together with someone not from Hinamizawa. It's not as if they had any ulterior motives. That's it. Yeah, that has to be it. Thinking about it that way, it was the same with Rena. I was just being strangely ambiguous about when I met Oishi-san. And Rena was just correcting me on that. That's when I was bewildered by the change in character from the usual mild-mannered Rena, and was just startled by it. That's the most natural way of thinking about it. It felt like my mind was mixed up, like a tangled mess of spaghetti. Deep red marinara sauce would have poured out my nose and ears if you squeezed my head. What an interesting thing to think about. Thinking that, I suddenly felt like vomiting. Yeah, me too. I really didn't want that to happen, so I stopped holding my head. Lately, I had no idea what anyone was saying. Spending time with them was fun. It didn't feel like there was any sort of hidden agenda. I really do think that they're a good bunch of people. When I just moved here and couldn't make heads or tails of everything, they were really kind to me. Rena was really kind and always looked after me. As long as that strange affliction didn't rear its ugly head, she was really pretty cute. Myun is also a really good person. She didn't care about anyone's age or gender, and was optimistic and outgoing. I was never bored when I was with her. And talking of not getting bored, rambunctious Satoko was a good person for that, too. She was pretty bratty, but that was just the way she interacted with others. Rika-chan was the same way. She didn't speak often, but that didn't mean she was always silent. They're my friends! But after hearing... What is this creepy sound? You know what? I shouldn't ask, what is this creepy sound in Higurashi, but... After hearing of the better untold secrets of Hinamizawa from Oishi-san and Tomatake-san, when I was told about Oyashiro-sama's curse, things started getting crazy. Then hearing from Oishi-san that Mion, Rena, Satoko, and Rika-chan were all suspicious, after that, everyone changed. That's right. It all started getting weird after Oishi-san told me all of that strange stuff. Wow, that's actually pretty cool, the way that the visual novel is telling the story here. Obviously, I know why, but it's not something you would pick up on first, I don't think, in your first playthrough. At that time, I really should have just not listened to those weird stories. I shouldn't have even asked Tomitake-san about the past incidents on the night of Watanagashi. If I just hadn't gotten that strange sense of curiosity, if I just hadn't... That's right! So that's why they... What? So that's why they fucked Tomitake-san. Why is it censored? Do I have a censored thing turned on or something? Hold on a minute. Can I see? Okay, it's... I like how it tells me what song is playing and what sound is... Cave is playing right now, apparently. And insects. Can I open the mod menu? Can I not open the mod menu from in the actual... Huh. Just voice. Change voice matching level. See, I have it on zero, so that we have uncensored. Yeah, right here. Minimum. Original PC script. With voices where it fits. Fully uncensored. Default level 2. Yeah, see, I have it on zero, I'm pretty sure. Maybe it's just... I don't know, maybe it's just censored here. Is it supposed to say killed, but that's a bad word? That impudent outsider speaking to the likes of me after everybody went out of their way to keep it for a secret from me. They'll probably fuck Oishi-san as well. Okay, I think it says kill, but for some reason that's censored. For trying to unearth what everybody was warning me was better left buried. Besides that, he was unforgivable for spewing words that made me doubt the others. Of course a guy like that is going to be fucked. Can you stop with this, please? Both Tomitake-san and Oishi-san were nothing but outsiders, after all. They were entities who couldn't coexist with the people of Hinamizawa. Those guys should just fall to Oyashiro-sama's curse and just die. Wow, that's kind of harsh, Keiichi. It wasn't their fault. It was my fault for not being able to hold back my curiosity. It wasn't their fault. 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 I settled into a daze. It was a lethargic feeling, like I had just gotten up, but the ominous chill that haunted me had subsided. I was fine now. I was no longer frightened. I had completely recovered. I'll go to school tomorrow, right as rain. I'll greet everyone. I'll take part in club activities. It'll definitely be fun. It had to be fun. I was one of them, after all.
そうだ。 おはぎ食べないと。
I remembered the homework the two brought with them when they visited me. But Wow, our club did delivery? That was something else. I picked up the package I dropped on the floor and headed into the living room. That is not the living room, that is the kitchen. It would be nice, I guess, to have some tea with it. To fill my mouth with mochi while drinking tea. Oh, this was quite a delectable situation I was in. I wouldn't know. The only tea I've ever tasted like you had dipped a stick into water, warmed it, and then left it there for an hour and then drank it. Opening up the newspaper wrapping, there were 5 plump red bean paste mochi fit snugly inside. Okay, so it was a bean paste. I'd have never tasted it, so I don't know if it's like sweet. There were letters written from left to right on the newspaper. A, B, C, D, and E. Now then, they said Rena made one of these. I wonder which one. There wasn't much difference in how they looked. They smelled and appeared about the same. This was a pretty difficult problem. The biggest difference was probably their shape. I wasn't sure what kind of person Mion's grandma was. Oh, I'm sure we'll find out. But Rena's had to be different from hers. Looking carefully, yeah, but grandmas make like the best pastries and stuff. I mean, come on. I could see one mochi that was made very neatly. So, well, that, just by staring at it, one could tell it stood out.
この一個がレナのか否かが勝負の分かれ目みたいだな。
Is my cat meowing, or is that in the game? That's kind of fucking creepy. Can you stop, please? Mion had said her grandma made a ton of them and was told to give some out, if I remember correctly. So that meant 4 of these were from that large batch. Then what about Rena? She probably only made 1? So she probably spent quite a bit of time on it. Meaning, the one Rena had made was the one... This one! E! For a moment, I thought it might have been a trap Mion laid, as she knew I'd pick up on it. But that probably wasn't the case. I wouldn't be so sure if I knew Mion and had made it, but since she said Rena made it, it probably wasn't a trap.
お茶も準備OK。まずはディフェンディングチャンピオンのミオンのばあちゃんからだ。どれ?
Alright, let's munch into this. Not bad. Smooth bean paste and soft, chewy texture left little to be desired. The tea I drank afterwards also accentuated the experience. This was an exquisite piece of work. Now how about Rena's? Creation was so delicate, one would think it was a high-class Japanese dessert. I put 2 S's in the dessert so you have... whatever, fuck it. Since I normally had quite the appetite, I was slightly worried about the size of the portion. But, well, first, how about just a bite? This was quite a difficult one to judge, actually. The ingredients were exactly the same, so there was little difference in flavor. What was different was how it was shaped at the end. So it was to be expected. So the deciding factors would be presentation and volume. The well-formed and well-sized champion versus Rena, the challenger, with a size you just couldn't get enough of. I'd only had 1 bite of Rena's. I would probably have to wait until after I was done eating to make my decision. Maybe there was something hidden inside that could cause an upset. Maybe you shouldn't chew it so hard. It seems my prediction was right. My tongue touched something. It didn't feel like something edible, so I reached in with my fingers and grabbed it. Boy, would I be fucking, I'd lose my whole appetite. Like, I find like a bone or something when I'm eating a piece of meat and, oh god, it's just, I'm done. I can't eat anymore. But what would be in mochi? Bean paste? Like maybe a hard bean stem? What? What is this? Before I could fully comprehend what it was, I threw away the rest of the mochi I was eating as fast as I could. It slammed against the wall, causing the bean jam to splatter. Then, after sticking for a moment, it slid down to the floor. I was dumbstruck by my own actions. What was I doing? Ren had gone out of her way to make it for me. How could I? Dumbstruck, I looked down at the hand that performed such a vile act. Then I remembered what I had taken out of my mouth. At first I thought it was a hair. Even though it was shorter than Mion's, Rena's hair was still quite long. And it wasn't this short. It was also a bit too hard to be hair. It was thick enough to roll around my tongue. There was a bit of a metallic sheen on the end of it. Ah, yes. There was a hole for where thread goes through, like a sewing needle. That's right. It looked very much like a sewing needle. Exactly like a sewing needle. The end was pointed as well, quite sharply. It really did look like a sewing needle. What? What did I mean by looked very much like a sewing needle just a bit ago? I couldn't answer, but a voice inside me already knew, and let me know by chattering my molars together. I couldn't stave off the terror welling up inside me. Suddenly, I tasted something metallic and felt a prickling pain at the back of my throat. Stuck my finger in the back of my mouth and felt around to see if I was bleeding. Suddenly, I felt the urge to vomit. The sharp taste of bile irritated the back of my throat. I collapsed, both hands over my mouth, and, after writhing in agony, I was somehow able to hold back the nausea. I was finally able to breathe normally again, but this time my heart was throbbing intensely. Then it finally registered exactly what was mixed in with the mochi. Before I could think of the correct word, my hands were already on the move. Splat, plop, splort. Some interesting sound. I tossed the rest of the mochi against the wall. Ew. The geometrical patterns of the scattered bean jam on the wall suddenly invoked a terrible omen in my mind. After looking away, I dashed out to the hall and flew upstairs to my room where I stayed under my covers until morning. I clutched my own shoulders, howling madly in a mix of fear, anger, sadness, and frustration. This wasn't a threat or warning or reminder. Nothing as simple as that. What had happened in Hinamizawa? What is happening in Hinamizawa? What would happen? I didn't know the answer to any of those questions. Where did I break a taboo? Regardless, now Rena and Mion and others, they consider me an enemy. And they thought I should just die. I won't let you kill me. Not for such a pointless reason. I fell into a restless sleep as I was crushed by my negative emotions. It was as if I was being drawn into a billowing, bottomless swamp. Why do I hear seagulls? Are we at the beach? Is it the beach episode time? Let's see. New tips unlocked. A drug that makes you kill yourself? Wait, how do I get to the chip? Oh, I got an achievement. Hard to swallow. Well, that's definitely an iconic Higurashi moment that I just witnessed for the first time in visual novel form. I would like to view the new tips. Threat. What's a drug that makes you commit suicide?
単刀直入に自殺させる薬ってないんですか?直接的にはない。遠回しですね。では間接的にはあるってことですか?自殺したくなる精神状態を誘発することはできるっていうことだ。 難しい言い方になりましたね。何ですか、その自殺したくなる精神状態ってのは。例えば、一般的な心理学見地から言えばじゃが、心理面が内向状態から外向状態に転じる時に、最も自殺が多いと言われちょる。
Clinical depression and bipolar disorder are different. Clinical depression indicates a prolonged state of depression, whereas bipolar disorder is characterized by a passive depressed state accompanied by a very active manic state.
内向状態の時は自信を喪失し非常に悲観的だ。だが自殺もせん。 自殺をする気力すらないからだ。
Oh my god. Okay.
逆の状態もまた自殺をせん。今度は逆に非常に自信過剰で行動的なので、自らを順風満帆と思う。だから自殺などせんのだ。
なるほどね。どっちの状態でも自殺をしないのに、状態が入れ替わるときに自殺するんですか？
内向状態には自殺願望はあるが、自殺という大仕事を遂げる気力すらもない。だが外向状態が始まると徐々に気力が充実し、体の自由が利くようになってくる。
なるほど。つまり自殺する気力が回復するわけですね。
そういうことじゃの。だからこの時期に変な気を起こさんように処方箋を施すわけじゃな。
では富武氏はこの心理状態だったんですかね。
一般的に自殺はちゃんとした文化的な手法で行われる。道具を使用してな。
You know, more civilized means hanging yourself.
自虐行動とは全く違うぞい。
富武氏の自殺は文化的じゃないですよね。ではやっぱり何かの中毒と考えるのが自然ですか。最初に言った自殺したくなる精神状態を起こす薬ってのを教えてください。
鎮痛薬の一部には心理を内向から外向に過剰転換させる効果があると報告されとる。
Okay, well I mean you know, looks can be deceiving, but I don't think Tomotake is a meth, you know, meth user. Just saying. He doesn't look like one to me.
それから、催眠作用を持つ薬を異常摂取した場合にも、異常行動が報告されとるが、あまり一般的ではないの。
I don't know what that is, but I could see him having to take sleeping drugs.
その二つは、検視の報告だと違うみたいですね。他の可能性は？
Oh, shit. Never mind.
あとは、病気しか考えられん。甲状腺異常を引き起こす病気にしばしばそれに似た症状が報告されとる。だがそれらは概して特徴的な症状が多い。仏は違うの。
もっと突発的に発生するものはありませんかね。今回のケースと合うような突発性で自殺したくなるようなやつです。
他には？そうじゃな、脳障害によって精神に異常を発生する状態じゃな。
Organic mental disorder.
これは薬物中毒でも起こるが、脳の外傷や一部の病気なんかでも起こる。
つまり薬によらなくても異常な精神状態に陥る可能性があると。
Can you see my mouse on the screen? Oh shit, maybe I should remove that so you guys don't have to see the mouse.
仏は犯人に囲まれて命に危険が迫っとったんじゃろ。極度の緊張が続いて、それに分泌異常が重なって、さらに打ちどころが悪くて脳に障害が起こり、自虐行動に走った可能性もあるかもしれんの。
もうちょっと省略して言ってくれませんかね。
つまり乱闘中に豆腐の角に頭ぶつけて、それで異常が発生したと言っとるんだ。
じゃあ星には殺意はなかったってことですかね。ちょいと小銭を巻き上げようと思ったら、たまたま殴りどころが悪かったと。
The two plump men. Nice.Laughed horse.
なんてわけはありませんね。
ふわはん。いかにも。薬物の常用にせよ、精神的なものにせよ、仏の身元が鍵を握っとるぞい。そっちはどうなっとるんじゃ。
あら、こんな時間。そろそろ戻らないと、クマちゃん怒っちゃいますね。
おお、頑張れよ。いいお年をの。
いいお年を。
Oh man, I like these tips a lot. It's... you know... I... Not to get, like, really personal, sentimental or anything, but I really am happy that I watched Higurashi, the anime, because that was a special experience for me the first time through. But there's a part of me that kind of wishes I would have been able to play the visual novels as my first exposure to Higurashi. And technically, I have the chance to experience something from this author. That's Umineko. I've known nothing about that except its relations to Higurashi. So I could... Those visual novels would be 100% blind to the story and everything else. But still... still, it's a lot of fun, though. I can't get enough Higurashi. I could absorb this shit for the rest of my life, for the rest of eternity, until the last light in the universe burns out. I could be absorbing all of this shit. But... Okay, so we've got another tip here that's simply titled Threat. And I don't know why we can't go 5 minutes without... Some sort of, I apologize if you can hear too much background noise. Doesn't seem to be stopping, even though it's 1 a.m. now. National Diet Badges.
じゃあ、県議と市議のその先だ。面白いっすね。 親戚同士で県議と市議やってんすか。これがずるいんですよ。お互いの名前で事前運動バンバン。片方の選挙中にはもう片方が別に後援会を開いて二重に選挙運動やってんですよ。堂々と。よくわかんないんすけど、それって公選法違反じゃないんすか。
事前運動にならない限り政治活動は無制限ですからね。クマちゃん、そんなんじゃ戦隊本部好きになった時大変ですよ。Okay,
so it's Kuma that's talking. I didn't recognize the name Kumagi.
公選法くらいは勉強してください。俺、知能犯科は無理っす。Kuma-gai、actually.
There was Prefectural Assembly member Sonozaki and City Councilor Sonozaki. Also the mayor of Hinamizawa. So they're all influenced by the Sonozaki family. What crap. It came to me. That night, when the department chief invited me along to get some Odin, the thought that was it. Oh, this is awesome. That artwork was great.
おいさんは友達多いから聞いてるかもしれないけど、聞いてるかな。いえ、何も。お母さん、ガモに半片頼みます。省庁んとこに議員の怒鳴り込みがあったんだよ。あれま、そうなんですか。あ、お母さん、私にもう一杯ください。
Prefectural Assembly member Sonozaki and City Councilor Sonozaki were both intimidating. Our snot-nosed career police chief couldn't handle being yelled at by them. They're like Yakuza.
ひなみざわ事件の捜査の仕方で君を指名して陳情してきたよ。ありゃ私?はてはて。とぼけるなよ。例のひなみざわの過去の事件。蒸し返してるだろ? 私、富竹殺しで手一杯でそんな余裕ないですよ。Okay,
so this is still post Tomitake's death.
本当に? 本当にそうならいいんだけどさ。There
was a period of silence. While we were silent, we made headway on our food and drink. I'll take a drink too.
いやー、ごちそうになっちゃいました。 今月は負けっぱなしだったんで財布つらかったんですよ。
Sorry, I was admiring the background artwork. This is the console artwork that I'm using, I think, so someday I'll have to play through the game with the original stuff. But this just screams, I would love to, late at night, just walk down the street as like a late night walk. Beautiful houses and buildings. It's dark. There's just lit by street lamps and the occasional house light and the occasional car. Beautiful trees coming. I don't know. I just, fuck it, whatever.
Tasukarimashita.
Yeah, iyo. Mata uma oshiete yo. Oi san to onaji uma o kau kara.
We're horse betting now?
最近はダメです。 馬の声がさっぱりですから。タクシ
ー。 I'm going by train. The department chief has taken a taxi. I have my own car, but it'd be rash to drive it home. Can't blow it right before retirement with a DUI. I guess we're drunk. Even though he could still rattle off, it looked like his legs were already jelly. Pushing him into the cab, I gave the driver the department chief's address.
ではではまた明日。良いお年を。
大井さん。
はいはい。
過去の事件は全部個別に終わってる。縦に並べるのはやめるんだよ。村の連中は半ば本気でたたりを信じてるんだから。
私だってたたりなんか信じちゃいませんよ。
大井さんは来年で退職じゃないですか。退職金でローン返して。お母さんと北海道に引っ越すんじゃなかったっけ？
ばあ様がどうしても生まれの北海道に帰りたいって泣くんですよ。最後のご奉公なんです。
Oishi has a mother? Holy shit, she must be ancient.
退職金は、まあ、歓楽街で楽しむことにします。
Well, I guess are my parents in their 50s too?Their mothers are still alive.
No.
所長は退職時特別昇給を見直すかもってさ。
A public servant's severance payment is calculated based on their monthly salary when they retire. So, a special promotion of two pay grades is given before retirement. This tops up the employee's severance payment. That tends to be how it's done around here.Of course, it's not exactly a commendable custom. Incidentally, the difference that two pay grades makes to the payout is quite significant.
さすがインテルの若所長は言い出すことが模範的です。でもまあ、私たちの給料が血税で支払われてることを思えば、まあ、時代の流れですかね。
It certainly wasn't a laughing matter, but I'll laugh through it anyway.
僕も模範的なこととは思わないよ。でもまあ、大石さんはそれだけの退職金をもらってもおかしくない活躍をしてきたからさ。僕としてはぜひもらってほしいんだよ。
もらえるもんならそりゃ欲しいですけどね。
もらえるよ。大石さんが大人なら。
運転手さん、引き止めてすみませんね。お願いします。
I closed the door roughly, interrupting the department chief's conversation a bit rudely. It looked like he still had something to say, but he just smiled wryly and waved. I waved in return. The cab sped up gradually and soon disappeared among the sea of lights. Scarily close, Oishi. Alone? Oishi? Okay, so those are the two new tips. Those are enjoyable. Okay, I'm going to... Yeah, let's save. I will, just in case something funky happened, I will save a new thing.So, February 3rd, 2023, at 1:19 in the morning, end of chapter 9. Okay. Let's go ahead and continue, and then I think I'll cut the video there. And then see if everything's working alright, and if it is, then we can play more.